I'm Allysia, and welcome to another episode of pianoTV. So today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the waltz, both the dance and the music form, but more so the music form. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna talk about how it works and what it is, and we're gonna listen to some famous examples on both the piano and the orchestra so you can get a good sense of what the waltz is supposed to sound like. And I'm doing this for next week when I, spoiler alert, provide a waltz tutorial on the website, so this just gives you a little bit of background info. All right, let's hop to it. All right, so what is a waltz? A waltz was a popular song form back in the 1800s or the Romantic era, especially in Vienna, which was kind of like still is a big musical hub in Europe. Though a lot of waltzes were written to be danced to, some composers instead decided to transform the genre to be purely instrumental and just to be listened to. So an example of this that we're going to listen to really quick is Chopin's Minute Waltz. You could not dance to this if you tried. Waltzes were composed in triple meter, so usually 3/4 time, and they have like a bop bop rhythm with one chord per bar. So generally the way it works is a low bass note is played for the first beat, and then the other two beats, beat 2 and 3, fill out the chord just a little higher on the piano, so you get something that sounds like this. So you hear feature of the waltz too is you'll notice that beat 1 and 2 tend to slur together, so instead of just 1, 2, 3, it's kind of like the second two beats are light, but the first and the second beat drag into each other. So this type of pattern you probably heard before even in modern music, because composers like Adele have used it in their songs. I think her song is called First Love, if you want to listen to that, that has that same pattern. So the waltz as a dance was actually considered rather risque, since it's a couples dance that needs the couples to stand pretty close together. The character of the waltz is very like kind of smooth and elegant and graceful, which when you're interpreting it on an instrument like the piano, basically just means that it's going to have a moderate tempo, about 70 beats per bar, which actually ends up feeling pretty fast when you're playing it, with nice elegant melodies. One of the most famous waltzes of all time is Johann Strauss's Blue Danube Waltz. So I guarantee you've heard it. We'll play it in a second here, but it has literally been played hundreds of times in movies and all kinds of things, from everything from 2001 Space Odyssey to The Simpsons to Titanic to, I could probably keep going. Among the most famous composers of waltzes for the piano are Johannes Brahms and Frédéric Chopin. So we'll talk about Brahms first. Now, he loved waltzes. He was even known to have said that he wished and lamented that he didn't write the Blue Danube Waltz because he loved it so much. But he didn't compose a whole ton of them, but the ones he did compose are pretty famous. So the one we're gonna play here today is his waltz in A-flat major. It's number 15 from his 39th opus. And it's got that like characteristic sentimental romantic flair that Brahms brings to the table. So one of my personal all-time favorite piano waltzes is the one by Chopin from his Opus 64, number 2. This is the waltz in C-sharp minor. It's really beautiful. I'm gonna get you to listen to it. I wanna see if you can hear that but kind of pattern that we talked about earlier being so characteristic of waltzes. And I also want you to think about this. When you're listening to it, do you think Chopin was writing the kind of waltz that was meant to be listened to or danced to? Thank you. And to conclude our discussion on waltzes, I wanted to show you an orchestral waltz by Tchaikovsky from the 1900s. This is from his Sleeping Beauty Ballet. Now, you probably recognize that title from Disney. And in fact, if you grew up watching Disney's Sleeping Beauty, you'll recognize the song too that I'm about to show you. So in the Sleeping Beauty movie, this song has the title Once Upon a Dream. So it's a pretty famous children's tune. That is all for our discussion on waltzes, but I want you to throw in your opinion in the comments. If you think that I skipped like a really awesome waltz, or just let me know what your favorite happens to be. Because of time, you know, the time frame that I have for these videos, I can't do like the 50 zillion waltzes that are out there that are popular. So I just kind of handpicked a few of my personal favorites, but I'd like to hear what yours are as well. So yeah, please leave that below in the comments. And if you haven't already, just visit pianoTV.net because that's where I post all these videos aside from YouTube, which you can subscribe to if you haven't already. Thank you for watching and catch you next time. What are you doing, you little weirdo?